Welcome back. It is 9:05. Thank you very much for joining us. We're going to be talking about a new period drama, Beecham House, which has been dubbed Delhi's Downton Abbey. It's stunning, set in India, and it's going to come to our screens this week.
Directed by Bend It Like Beckham's Gurinder Chadha, the drama follows the fortunes of the residents of an imposing, beautiful mansion in Delhi called Beecham House. This is the cusp of the 19th century.
We're going to talk to Gurinder and one of the stars of the series, Dakota Blue Richards. Morning. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Just in a moment. First, take a look.
In a garden full of beautiful flowers, I see your eyes have rested on the only English rose.
I was surprised, that's all.
It is a rarity in Delhi. Come, I should like to introduce you.
And Grid is just busy saying really nice things about Dakota. What did you just say? You're like, what?
I said she looks like a Rembrandt painting in,
because
in
of
this
the,
clip.
The whole, the look, because the big hair.
The
whole
lighting, how she's sitting.
Let me ask you, Grinda, the bar is set high these days for TV dramas and what we expect, you know, the visual feast we're expecting. You must be so conscious of that.
Yes, I'm a little nervous, to be honest with you, because there's been so much talk about Beecham House. And here I am again talking about it. I'm now feeling like, my gosh, there's so much expectation. But, you know, we just have to rise to it. You know, I love Sunday night drama. That's my thing. I know there's lots of streaming channels and I know everyone binge watches. But for me, that Sunday night slot is critical. And I've been enjoying Gentleman Jack as well, you know. And I think that to sit there as a family together and watch a drama unfold and wait for the next episode is all part of my growing up, and I hope the audience enjoys Beecham House on that level, because for me that Sunday night drama is about transporting you into a different world through your characters. Not too taxing, a little bit intellectual, not too much, sumptuous, enjoyable and emotional.
There's a lot, you've demanded a lot from yourself to deliver.
Well, that's the story of my life, isn't it? I'm always pushing and trying to get the best thing out there, and you know, that's what drives me. I mean, I love storytelling, and I've been working with an amazing cast on this.
Let's find out, Dakota. Tell us about your character in this.
My character is called Margaret Osborne, and she is a governess, and she's John's neighbour.
John's the main character.
John, the lead, played by Tom Bateman. And he is the first English woman... She is the first English woman that he has seen in years. And so they're instantly drawn to each other because they have this sort of English common ground, and very quickly develop a friendship.
I was just going to ask Dakota, so you filmed in London, but also in India.
Yes.
So was this a big learning curve for you about it's sort of a cultural experience at the same time as being an acting challenge?
I suppose so. I mean, I didn't find working in India to be challenging particularly. I thought it was a wonderful experience.
You look after people.
Yeah. To be honest, it felt so much like such a well-oiled machine, and everything just sort of kept rolling constantly, and you know, the ball never stopped the whole time we were there. So it was just wonderful.
I think it helps with me being British and Indian. Mm-hmm. So with the, you know, the British crew, I'm one way, in the British cast, and with the Indian crew and the Indian cast, I can be like them. So on when we're waiting for shots and waiting for lighting, sometimes I'll put my speaker on and I'll burst into a Bollywood song, and all the Indian crew are all like, oh, dancing with me. You know? And then with the English crew, we've got scenes in a fort, you know, and every now and again I'd put the mic on and I'd go, one day more, and none of the English crew would join in. That's the difference.
Well, Price, is that, I would imagine that's unusual for a director to do that kind of thing. You maybe know, I don't know. Is that out of keeping with what they would normally do?
I would say that working with Gurinder has been totally unlike any other experience I've had in this industry.
Why? How different is she?
I mean, there's you have such a passion, which I think is absolutely essential, but it's such sort of vibrancy, and Gurinder will always tell you what she wants, and she always gets it one way or another. But it's great to to have a leader who has such a strong vision and really knows how to achieve it.
Brenda, I see we're just looking at some of the images of the filming itself.
Yes.
I imagine, I mean, just looking at it, the attention to detail and the sumptuousness of the time and the way things looked. I mean, in a way, it's a gift to a filmmaker, isn't it?
Oh, gosh, yes. I mean, that's the great thing about India. You can literally point your camera in any direction and all of life is there. What you've got to do is contain it because there's so much, you know, and you can go crazy. But, yes, it's period. It's 1795. It's before the British Raj. John Beecham and Margaret, to some degree, are there as immigrants. They're English, coming to this new land, trying to make a life for themselves. And as the story unfolds, they both have a past. You know, we learn about Margaret Osborne's past, which I won't give away. They're all the actors are sort of having to play roles where you don't quite know what's going on, and that's very delicious in amongst all these beautiful landscapes in Jaipur. We shot in Jaipur, which is a very Mughal city, for the right architecture. So I think that I grew up with Jewel in the Ground and Far Pavilions.
People, and, you know, of a certain age, I remember and they were exactly that, weren't they? There was dramas. Of course, in those days, you had to sit and watch them when they went out.
Yes,
you know,
absolutely.
That's probably where all that
But they were from. Compelling, you know, yeah. And I really liked Jewel in the Crown because I think it was trying to do something different, you know. I remember that distinctly. And I think with Beecham House, you know, we've come a long way. And one of the great things for me with Polly Hill, who commissioned the drama, the first thing she said to me was, I want to do this, but I want you to know that the Indian characters are just as important to me as the English characters. Now, I've been in the business for God knows how many years, that is the first time an executive has said that to me. And I was like chuffed. I was like, wow, we have come a long way. So I think it's important that we mark those moments too. And when we talk about diversity and everything, I think, you know, Beecham House is what it is because we had a whole team behind us who lived and breathed what it means to be part of, a multicultural society and an industry.
It is sumptuous. I think that's the word that's been used.
Thank you.
I think that is absolutely correct. Thank you so much.